Welcome to Grab & Go Info. This tutorial will talk about how to set up the Spark environment on Google Colab. Both the manual method and the automated method will be covered. If you are new to Google Colab, please check out my tutorial Google Colab Tutorial for Beginners. Let's get started. Firstly, let's talk about how to install Spark on Google Colab manually. Step 1.1. Download Java because Spark requires Java Virtual Machine. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is my most referenced website for data science and machine learning. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me and buy me a cup of coffee, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free posts each month for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. Step 1.2. Download the latest version of the Apache Spark following the steps below. 1. Go to https://spark.apache.org/downloads.html. 2. Choose a Spark release version and a package type. The default is the latest version. When this tutorial is published, the latest Spark release is 3.2.1, and the package type is pre-built for Apache Hadoop 3.3 and later. 3. Click the link for downloading Spark, and you will be directed to a new web page. 4. Copy the first link on the web page, which is below the sentence we suggest the following site for your download. 5. Download Spark from the copied link. 6. Unzip the file. Step 1.3. Set up the environment for Spark. Here we set up the paths for Java and Spark. Step 1.4. Install and import the library for locating Spark. Using findspark.find, we can get the location for the Spark. Step 1.5. Start a Spark session and check the session information. Step 1.6. Test if Spark is installed successfully by importing a Spark library. There is no error message after running the code, indicating that Spark is successfully installed. The second method of installing PySpark on Google Colab is to use pip install. After installation, we can create a Spark session and check its information. We can also test the installation by importing a Spark library. You might wonder which method to use for your project. I suggest using the pip install in most cases, and only consider the manual method if you would like to customize certain settings for the installation. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about Google Colab, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.